STEM with COG. Electrify, Part 1. It's an extraordinary time to be alive. We understand how burning fossil fuels releases excess carbon dioxide that causes climate change. And if you don't understand, feel free to binge watch episodes 1 through 11 of STEM with COG. And the best bit is that knowing what causes it tells us how to fix it. We have an abundance of solutions. What we need now are climate-friendly economic policies and the will of the people to take on big projects, like the project to electrify everything. Well, almost everything that transports, glows, heats, cools, or runs machines. But wait, why would we want to create bigger demand for electricity when making it is already pumping gigatons of CO2 into the atmosphere every year? Why electrify? Because we can produce electricity without burning fossil fuels. This isn't just a crazy dream. We can do it. Let's start with transportation. We can start driving electric vehicles, EVs. In episode 5, we looked at how an internal combustion engine burns gasoline to turn the wheels of your car, but also dumps CO2 into the atmosphere. Now let's see how clean electric cars work. To make the body of the car, you'll need craft sticks, glue gun, craft cubes with holes, 2 axles and 4 wheels. And to get the car body moving, you'll need a motor, battery pack with an on-off switch, and gears. Now let's build it. Oh, the battery's connected to the motor, and the motor's connected to the ring gears. The ring gears are connected to the axles that spin the wheels of the car. Them wheels gonna spin around. Them wheels gonna spin around. Them wheels gonna... Well, you get the idea. It kind of seems like magic is happening in the motor. How does it turn electrical energy into mechanical energy of a spinning rotor? Let's see how the interaction between a magnetic field and the flow of electrons through a copper wire caused that spin. This permanent magnet will do. Then, to get the electrons flowing, we need a battery, copper wire, 2 paper clips to complete a circuit. First, we'll stabilize the battery with clay. Now configure and attach the paper clips with more clay and electrical tape. Attach the permanent magnet with clay. Time to make a copper coil. Now sand off the insulation on one side of the wire. When this side is up, the wire connects with the paper clips and electrons flow. You can use permanent ink on the other side to help stop electron flow when the ink contacts the paper clips. Push the paper clips in, and tui-tui, electricity in, mechanical spin out. That spins the wheels of the car. My toy motor looks like this inside. The motor in electric vehicles is also made of magnets and copper wire coils, just more of them, and they're bigger. But do electric cars really release less CO2 than gas cars? Let's take a look at this graph from Argonne National Labs in the United States. It shows that in the U.S., electric cars release much less CO2 than gas cars over the lifetime of a car. Sure, making the lithium-ion battery produces CO2, but day-to-day driving more than makes up for that because electric cars are much more efficient and the electricity that powers them is cleaner than gasoline, even now. But just imagine the future. If we could recharge our car batteries with clean electricity, we could eliminate this gray area that represents CO2 released while making electricity. Wow! But how do we do that? Wind and solar energy. They don't release any CO2 when they make electricity. Here's how they work. Most electricity is produced with a generator. Generators, like motors, are made of magnets and copper coils. In our motor, electricity went in and the spin was produced. In generators, the spin goes in and electricity is produced. I made a simple generator in episode 4. I spun the generator with my fingers. Usually, a turbine spins the generator. But what spins the turbine? Well, in this case, the name says it all. It's a wind turbine. And wind power turns the blades that spin the generator to make electricity. No CO2 is produced in the process. Wind is a great source of energy. And it's free. Of course, you gotta buy the wind turbine and the tower and maintenance and so on. Now let's talk about solar energy. The sun's energy falling on Earth in 1 hour could power the Earth for a year. And one way to capture some of that energy is in a solar tower. This solar tower focuses the sun's heat energy using mirrors. That heats up a liquid that ultimately makes steam.
That steam turns a turbine, like this one.
It's kind of like a pinwheel, but it won't spin with a gentle puff of air. You gotta blast it with superheated, pressurized steam.
When it does spin, it turns a generator that makes electricity.
It's the same process as the coal-fired power plant in episode 4, except instead of burning dirty coal, we use clean heat from the sun. The solar tower does not produce CO2 or other pollutants like burning coal.
But
most solar electricity is produced using photovoltaic or PV cells. These cells turn the sun's light energy into electricity directly without producing any CO2 as they work. No turbines or generators needed. They can be small, like the one that powers this dancing hula flamingo. Or you can put a bunch of cells together to make these awesome PV panels on my roof. My panels transform light from the sun into electricity for my computer, my lamps, my refrigerator, my air conditioning, my washer and dryer, and they do it for free. Well, almost. It took us 5 years to pay them off, and in the next 5 years, we've saved over $5,000 in electricity bills. We can really scale up using PV panels to create solar farms like this one that can supply a whole town with electricity. But there's a downside to solar and wind power plants. They only make electricity intermittently while the wind blows or the sun shines. And we use electricity all the time. So let's recap. We can transition away from burning fossil fuels that release excess ancient CO2 into our atmosphere by driving electric cars, trucks, and buses. EVs already produce a lot less CO2 than gasoline-powered vehicles. If we could recharge their batteries with CO2-free electricity, like that from wind and solar, we'll really be helping to control climate change. Electricity from solar and wind farms is generated intermittently, but we use electricity all the time. Is this a problem we can solve? To find out, watch Electrify Everything, Part 2.